It's Mary, and welcome to the Dressing Room Diaries. As always, I hope you guys had an amazing week. Today, we are so lucky and really honored to have with us as a special guest an incredibly talented engineer and the actual inventor of the magic toy making machine that is used today up at the North Pole. Not only is he that, but currently he is the number one best-selling author of the Santa scandalous book, Bad Things About Santa Claus. Yes, that's right. We have the elf himself, Bushy Evergreen, is here.
Thanks, Mary. Thanks for having me on your show.
Thank you for joining us today, Bushy. Well, let's get to it. What prompted you to write this book?
About 300 years ago, I invented the magic toy-making machine. Well, it's recently come to my attention that Santa Claus put a patent on my machine. Well, I work for him, I understand that. But, you know what he did, Mary? You know what he did? He patented it and didn't put my name on the patent. So, I go to Santa and I say, Santa, could I please have my name on the patent of my machine? And you know what he said to me? You know what he said to me, Mary? Ho, ho, ho. That's what he said. Ho, ho, ho. Payback's a bitch, Claus.
Bushy, this is Santa Claus we're talking about, and everybody thinks he's wonderful. So, can you please give us some examples from your book about the bad things that Santa actually does?
Well, that's why I'm here, Blondie. Let's start off with a couple of small things. At the toy workshop, there isn't enough parking. Not enough parking. Santa's always the first one to get there in the morning. And he pulls his sleigh in, and it takes up two parking spaces. Park between the white lines, Mr. Magoo. Is that such a big problem? And speaking of the sleigh, everybody knows the sleigh's drawn by reindeer. Well, he lets the reindeer run loose all over the parking lot. You know what that means? You know what that means, Mary?
No, I don't.
Reindeer poop. That's what it means. Reindeer poop all over the parking lot. Well, the elves come in and they walk through the parking lot and they step in the poop and they track the poop through the workshop. They track reindeer poop through the workshop. Somebody's gotta clean that up, Claus.
Gross.
You're telling me.
What else?
Cookie crumbs.
How is that a problem?
Santa eats cookies all day long, and he gets all the crumbs in his beard. Well, you want to walk around with crumbs in your beard? That's up to you. But he gets the crumbs all over the shop. All over the shop. Somebody's got to sweep that up, Claus. Which ties into the next complaint. After eating all those cookies all day long, Santa has to have milk to wash them down with. Well, he goes over to the refrigerator and drinks some milk.
How is that a problem?
That's not the problem, Mary. He takes an empty milk carton and puts it back into the refrigerator. He puts an empty milk carton back in the refrigerator. So making toys, that's thirsty work. So us elves, we go over to the refrigerator, open it up to get a glass of milk for ourselves, we reach in there, grab the carton, and it's an empty milk carton. You use the last of the milk, throw the carton away, Santa. Is it that big of a deal?
I can imagine that can be annoying.
And wash your hands once in a while, Santa. Santa eats 40 or 50 candy canes a day. And then he gets all that sticky candy cane all over his hands. Then he goes out in the workshop and touches everything. Then when you go to turn something on or off, you get the sticky all over your hands. Wash your hands every once in a while, Santa. Somebody has to wipe down that machinery. So, after a few pounds of cookies, and 2 or 3 gallons of milk, and 40 or 50 candy canes, he goes in the workshop bathroom to take his daily dump. Well, he's in there forever, and then after he comes out, nobody else can use it for a long time. It's like having the Incredible Hulk use your bathroom. P.U. It's like having the Incredible Hulk take a dump in your bathroom.
Ooh, yuck. What else?
So Santa records all of the Ellen DeGeneres show on his DVR. Then he goes into his office and binge watches them for hours. And we always know when he's doing it because we can hear him ho-ho-hoing from out in the workshop. Then, when Ellen dances, Santa dances. He shakes the whole building. Who can work under these conditions? It's just weird.
I have to ask, in all honesty, considering the world economy, the job market, and the fact that, let's be honest, you're a seasonally employed Christmas elf. So I don't know, other than the North Pole, where you're going to be getting a whole lot of work. Don't you think that maybe with this book, you're biting the hand that feeds you, and you should maybe just lighten up on Santa just a teeny bit and let some of these, now they're annoying, really annoying habits, but maybe you should just let them go? Maybe?
Listen here, Blondie, I'm just getting warmed up. Taylor Swift has been on the naughty list 3 years in a row. 3 years in a row! And Santa still brings her a present every year. And something nice, too.
What are you implying, Bushy?
I think you can figure that one out for yourself, Blondie.
Okay, we're gonna wrap this up with that right now. So, Bushy, thank you so much for being here. We have absolutely enjoyed having you at the Dressing Room Diaries. And of course, your nationwide number one best-selling book, Bad Things About Santa Claus, is available for purchase at all the usual places.
Thanks for having me. I'm coming for you, Claus!
From all of us here at the Dressing Room Diaries, from myself, from Johnny, Jimmy, and Moriarty, we'd truly like to wish everyone a happy holiday season, Merry Christmas, and we will see you all very soon here at the Dressing Room Diaries. Bye-bye.